Hey, you like Israel? You like Torah? Sign up for our Israel National Torah newsletter at the link on the screen. This week's Torah reading of Bo lays the foundations for the Jewish calendar. God tells Moshe, HaChodesh HaZeh Lechem, Rosh Chodeshim. This month is the first of all months. But wait, there's a huge inconsistency in the Hebrew calendar. In Israel, the major Jewish holidays are celebrated one day, while outside of Israel, the very same holidays are celebrated for 2 days. So for example, in the spring, we Jews in Israel will celebrate the Passover Eve feast one night, while outside of Israel, the same Passover Eve feast will be celebrated for 2 nights. Imagine that. Thanksgiving being celebrated for 2 days, let's say west of the Mississippi River. That's nuts. A holiday is a holiday. It should be celebrated the same everywhere. The Talmud gives a technical explanation, but there's a deep spiritual one as well. The Jewish holidays don't just commemorate a historical event. Rather, they represent divine illuminations descending to the world on that date. Through celebrating the holidays, we receive these exalted energies. Dear brothers and sisters overseas, don't be upset with me for what I'm about to say. I'm quoting the Tzemach Tzedek, who quotes the Ramak, the famous 16th century Kabbalist from Tzfat. He says, Chutz la'aretz li'oto gashmi, eino yochol lekabel ha'ara b'yom achad, kamo she'mekabel et Eretz Yisrael. The diaspora, being materialistic, cannot receive the divine light in one day as the land of Israel can. He goes on to explain that Jews who dwell overseas in the diaspora suffer from richuk mi'elohut. They suffer from being distant from divinity. So it's like this picture of the solar panels on the school in Beit El where I live. It takes 2 cloudy days to generate the same amount of electricity as 1 sunny day because the clouds prevent the sun's energy from penetrating. So too, the Jewish calendar is teaching us that the Jews living outside of Israel are living behind dark spiritual clouds that prevent the divine light from reaching them as the light reaches the Jews in the land of Israel. What's the conclusion? Anyone who comes to the land of Israel is positioning himself to receive more divinity. So as we say at the end of the Passover celebration, Lshana Baaa b'Yerushalayim, next year in Jerusalem. Shuffle, 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 shuffle.